Jason here, Pyro Wizard Dragon, doing an upload this week for Bod Mod 101. This week's topic is tattoo schools versus apprenticeships. And I'm going to be talking about how I feel about both those things. First of all, let me give you a short update on my tattoos. I had 2 hours worked on my back just about an hour and 15 minutes ago. I finished that session. Check out my personal page, you can see the progress on my back tattoo. And this week I also had my piercings, two new piercings, lip piercings. I'm not sure what they're called, technically, whether they're alligator bites or Manitou bites or zebra bites or whatever they are. But to me, they're new lip piercings, so hopefully I don't offend somebody by calling them that. Anyways, this week's topic is, like I said, tattoo schools versus apprenticeships. And I have an opinion on this. I think that apprenticeships could be cool if the tattoo artist was cool himself. And cool, what I mean by cool is that if they really cared about teaching somebody during the apprenticeship, then I think a tattoo apprenticeship could be a good thing. But my experience has been quite the opposite. I have apprenticed under 3 different tattoo artists, and for the most part, they could care less what I was learning about. They cared how much creamer was in their coffee, and they cared how clean the bathroom was. They cared if I lied to cover their appointments that they were missing because they were drinking too much the night before, and they were hungover to the point where they couldn't tattoo a straight line. They cared about everything but teaching me how to tattoo. And when I finally was allowed to tattoo at shops where I was apprenticing, they didn't even watch me. They didn't teach me anything. And I did a lot of things incorrectly when I was apprenticing. It was almost 2 years ago. I apprenticed up in the mountains here in Colorado under a certain particular artist whom I shall not name because he was not a good tattoo artist. I mean, he was an amazing tattoo artist, but he was not very professional in the way he ran his business. And he didn't teach me a lot. So right now I'm enrolled in the Denver Body Art School. I've been there for approximately going on my 4th month, starting on the 3rd will be my 4th month that I started June 3rd, and so it's a little bit into September. I started tattooing about 3 weeks ago, and I made leaps and bounds in my tattooing knowledge and skills since I've started there. I've learned so much that I don't even have time to talk about everything I've learned in this video, but it's been a blessing to my life and to my dreams of pursuing a career in art, especially in tattooing, and piercing. I'm learning a lot about piercing also at the school. I have more than one teacher. I have 2 technical teachers. There's another guy that comes in about once a month for an accelerated program that teaches me stuff too. I've learned how to break down machines. I've learned about inks, needles, groupings, all kinds of stuff. And what's kind of neat is there's over 24 students there, so we all kind of teach each other and inspire each other. And I've been producing way better art even because one of the teachers is a really good artist, and she's instructed me not only in tattooing but also how to draw and to shade and perspective, and there's little packets we do as homework just to improve my art skills. You can see some of my art on my personal Facebook page if you'd like to see what I've been doing at the school. I did a couple portraits that turned out really nice. Other than that, I guess that's pretty much my opinion. I don't really want to talk too badly about apprenticeships, but some of them really suck, and they're expensive, and you don't learn a lot. Now, I'm not saying all of them are bad. I'm sure there's some wonderful tattoo artists out there, and maybe one day I will find another guy that will apprentice me, or girl. It just depends. I'd have to find the right person. I'd love to, you know, learn from other artists. And the advantage of going to the school versus an apprenticeship, too, is that I'm not just learning under one artist. My teachers, there's 2 of them, and there's all the students, so we all bounce information off each other, and you kind of develop your own style while you're at the school. And what you find out what works for you, and I get to try out a bunch of different inks, and it's just I get to try rotary machines versus coil machines, learn about business practices, and just all different types of aspects of the tattoo industry. So with that being said, I think I've said enough about it. I'm going to try to link together on this video. I did a short interview with my teachers just for fun. They were a little nervous, so give them a break. They're not used to doing YouTube stuff. So and maybe even a blooper reel at the end if I can fit it in. So other than that, thank you all for watching. Hopefully you like this video. If you have any questions about the Denver Body Art School where I'm going, feel free to ask me. I'd love to answer any questions. Give me a thumbs up, please. I'd appreciate it greatly. I hope you all are enjoying your life and your day, and I love you all. Thank you very much. Bye. This is Jason for BodMod 101, and this week's topic is tattoo schools versus apprenticeships. These are my instructors here at the Denver Body Art School, Sydney and Willow, and they're going to speak briefly about how they feel about tattoo schools versus apprenticeships. So how do you feel, Sydney, about apprenticeships and the traditional way of getting taught tattooing?
I don't have any disrespect for it. I just think it's not a learning style for everybody. You know, you go in, it's like a year of cleaning toilets and being ordered around. Maybe not every apprenticeship, but every one that I looked into, and it just wasn't for me. And I was determined to learn tattooing, and I really looked for an alternative way of learning, and so I discovered the school. And it was pretty much just a year of learning big variety of needles, different way to tattoo, inks, everything I needed to create my own style and become the artist I am today.
Awesome. How do you feel about tattoo schools versus apprenticeships?
I think the biggest thing is that we provide the bloodborne pathogens license for you, and we also provide complete certification for tattooing.
Have either of you apprenticed before at a shop?
I have. I apprenticed for 2 years. All I did was clean the toilets and pass out cards.
So you didn't learn a lot at your apprenticeship?
Not at all.
Well, that's cool. I've been here for about 4 months. I've apprenticed myself 3 different times under 3 different artists, and I can say I learned more here the first 3 weeks than I did at the previous 3 months of my last apprenticeship. So, other than that, thank you both for being part of the channel.
Oh, what round two? Never mind. I want to start differently. Can we do a different one?
Okay. Okay. No curse words. Okay, this is Willow on the left here, my left, and Sydney on the right. They are instructors, teachers here at the Denver Body Art School, and they're going to talk briefly about tattoo schools versus apprenticeships and how they feel about each of those things. So, whenever you're ready.
All right, so your basic apprenticeship is roughly anywhere from 1 to 3 years. First year, you're going to be cleaning machines. You're going to be mostly doing work for... No!
Come on, that was great.
3 needles. So a certain brand of inks, one way to do it. We'll teach you everything, even like different ways of how to be business partners. And wait, that's not those. I don't know. I'm so bad at this stuff. Hold on.
That was great.
This is Jason for BodMod 101. And this week's topic is tattoo schools versus apprenticeships.